Hi dear all. Today I'm sharing a video on Hinoxonlin purpura. The newer name of it is IgA vasculitis. We call it IgA vasculitis because there is deposition of the IgA in the affected organ. It is the most common type of vasculitis occurring in the children. It is a small vessel vasculitis. The most commonly affected age group is between 3 to 10 years, although it may affect any age. Usually the URTI, that is upper respiratory tract infection, triggers the disease, and it occurs because of the IgA deposition in the different organs. Like when the IgA deposition occurs in the skin, leads to the vasculitis, there is a rash which is the hallmark of the Hinoxonlin purpura. The rash is initially macular or maculopapular and later on turns into the palpable purpura. This palpable purpura is due to vasculitis. So here we need to note down that it is non-thrombocytopenic purpura. That is not because of the thrombocytopenia, it is due to the vasculitis. It is usually symmetrical, usually affects the lower limbs and buttocks. It occurs on the extensor aspect of the lower limbs and buttocks. Another common manifestation which occurs is involving the mesenteric vasculitis, that is affecting the GIT. If we note down in the GIT, the most common manifestation is in the form of abdominal pain. It may be so severe that it may mimic the surgical abdomen. It may also be associated with the nausea, vomiting. The complications like intussusception or perforation may also occur. When this IgA deposition occurs in the joint, it leads to the arthralgia, arthritis. Usually it involves the large joints like ankle and knees, but usually leads to no residual deformity in the joints. Another involvement which is very significant is renal involvement. It may lead to the isolated hematuria, proteinuria, hypertension, or there may be the presence of nephritic or nephrotic syndrome. Also, azotemia may be there. Rest of the organs like CNS vasculitis, Guillain-Barré syndrome, carditis or colitis may also occur. Now, if we talk of the diagnosis of the Hinoxonlin purpura, the diagnosis is entirely clinical. The lab things may only give the supportive evidence, but we have to make the diagnosis clinically. So if we see, according to the European League, the classification criteria for the childhood Hinoxonlin purpura is, there should be palpable purpura with at least one of the following. Now out of the four things, one should be present. We can remember it with the mnemonic DARP. That is, D stands for diffuse abdominal pain, A stands for arthritis or arthralgia, R stands for renal involvement, and B is suggestive of biopsy, which is suggestive of IgA deposition. So now we have a child who has a history of URTI and now has presented to us with the history of rash. Rash typically in the form of the palpable purpura involving the lower limbs and buttocks, and also there is abdominal pain and arthritis, or there may be or may not be renal involvement. So how you will treat this child? So clinically we have established the diagnosis of Hinoxonlin purpura. Now when we consider the treatment, the treatment is mainly supportive, so we need to maintain the hydration. We need to give the analgesics for the pain management. If there is severe joint or GI involvement in the form of the arthritis or in the form of severe abdominal pain, then we need to start with the prednisolone with 1 to 1.5 mg per kg per day for 2 to 3 weeks. Also, if there is severe renal involvement, then we have to go for the immunosuppressants like azathioprine or prednisolone or methylpred pulse therapy. Also, we may need plasmapheresis in such cases. Now, if we talk of the prognosis, if the age of the child is less than 6 years, the disease is usually self-limiting. It usually resolves in 4 weeks. But if the child is more than 6 years and if renal involvement is there, we need to do the long-term follow-up for the renal involvement up to 6 months, because in 1 to 5% of the cases, they usually end up into the end stage renal disease. Thank you.